Good afternoon, everybody. I want to tell you all something right now. And when I say you're going to listen to me, you're going to listen to me. And when I say markets are overbought and they're going to come down, you're going to listen to me. I'm telling you right now, the Dow Jones is down 239 points, NASDAQ 100, minus 80, S&P is down 27, and these indexes are tanking. I'm going to pull over, and here's a 60-minute chart. And that one there is on the NASDAQ composite on a 60-minute. And not only are you going to see it, here's what you're going to really enjoy. You're going to enjoy that the E-mini futures right now are down. And they've had a 45-point range. And they have. And they're down big. And that means that these markets in the E-mini, S&P E-mini futures, along with the E-mini index, it's down. They're selling off hard. You need to say one thing. I appreciate all of you enough to give you the NASDAQ composite. I am teaching you about a lot of things. And the thing that I'm teaching you about is how it started with the headline event, and it did. I'm going to put Amazon $27 down. I'm going to put total dollar range on Google, which is right here, and it was down. So one thing about all of it, you need to be able to see it, and you can see it right here. You can see that they came down, and the range is there. On Tesla is $1.54, but let it be known one more time. Here is the E-mini futures right now. They're going so fast that you cannot even see them. And I know that, you know that, and we always try to bring it to you, and you gotta listen. And the short side of the market is pain. Here is the E-mini futures right here. Right there, that's the E-mini. That's the S&P tanking. And they were down a lot more than that. And another thing I can tell you is that we are going to continue. We sold short and bought puts up here at 26.50. We had some 26.05s. We had some 6. We had 26.20. And we had 6.50 on the high. And they hit that high today, and that was the end of it, man. And right now, there it is on the S&P. Now, here's what I'm going to show you. I'm going to go to the NASDAQ 100, and I am right now. It's down 64 on the 60-minute. We've got Amazon catching a bid, too, and we're going to go over that. We are tanking in these markets. And I told everybody that that was going to happen. And that was before the fact. And this is a 60-minute chart on the NASDAQ composite. And we want you to see that. Hold on. I've got a 60-minute chart. I've got the December E-mini S&P 500. It came down here, and then they popped it. And this all happened as the markets are tanking. And we're just showing you right there that that is what's happening on this S&P as far as a 60-minute chart. See that big move down? You see that big move down? I know you see it. And this is a 60-minute. They got it back up to pivot line. The volatility will continue. And you better what? You better believe it. And I'm just telling you that. And not only that, here's the, once again, I'm going to show on the 60-minute chart, here's the futures. And not a lot of people don't see call charts, put charts on options or futures. And we hit the same, look at, they dived off the cliff and they hit that 62.60 and then they came back on that wick on the NASDAQ. I'm giving it all to you. I am telling you, we are not done going down. And we're going to go back to the So basically what I'm trying to tell everybody is when I show the Dow right now, futures, here it is. Here it is, people. Look and see. There it is on the 60 minute. They came in, here, let's blow it up better for you. And the put options are paying. And the call options are getting taken to the woodshed. He comes down on this 60 minute in the Dow, and then now they popped it back over here. And so that volatility right now, we were down well over 200 points. And this is the volatility on options expiration Friday. Anyway, I care about all of you, and we're going to put it on pause. So here we are right now, everybody. We have the volatility index. That volatility index was 25-year lows. That meant there was no fear in the market, and everybody was happy. And it also tells irrational exuberance. And when we peak today up here, this volatility index peaked right there. And that's 14%. So when that was happening on 11/29, we made the low, we came up, we consolidated it, and we broke out. This is the fear indicator. And you will know that once you make a high on it, and it comes down, then equities will also bounce to go up again. And it's a great tool. It's one that we mastered, and it's one that we use in the indexes, the volatility index, CBOE, volatility index. It's all right here. You can see it, and you can be involved with it.